Hello everyone. Welcome to FoodTech Network. If you haven't subscribed our YouTube channel yet, then subscribe it now. And don't forget to click on the bell icon. For regular updates, visit our website www.foodtechnetwork.in and join our groups. We share jobs, webinars, quizzes, trainings, news on daily basis. We never charge any consultancy fee for jobs. So the topic of our today's lecture is plastics in food industry. So plastic is a very common topic and we use it in our daily day-to-day life. So plastics form a very large comprehensive family of materials with a wide range of properties that can meet our almost every daily day-to-day requirements. And you know, we all generally use plastics for packaging, and so our topic is plastics in food industry na. So today we will learn how these plastics are helping in food industry for food packaging. Okay, so yes, so moving further, being man-made, plastic can be tailor-made to meet a specific requirement or achieve a combination of properties. Plastics is artificial, we cannot find it naturally. Okay, so plastic is an artificial product and we can alter it, and we can tailor it as according to our requirements. Okay, so as such, there will always be a polymer or a combination of polymers to meet almost every need. So what are plastics? Let's have a basic definition of plastic. Plastics are a wide group of solid composite materials which are largely organic and usually based on synthetic resins or upon modified polymers of natural origin and possessing appreciable mechanical strength. Okay, so at a suitable stage in their manufacture, most plastic can be coast molded and polymerized directly to shape. Okay, so let's read what is written here. So plastic is one of the most commonly used material in food industry for food packaging, and its role in food safety and reducing food waste has made it an essential material in the food industry. It is an easy to use product and it is very cost effective. Next point, plastic packaging can survive in extreme environments and don't easily degrade in hot and cold temperature. Now you will ask me questions like the plastic is plastic generally, or the polythenes we use generally melt at hot temperature, but they are low quality of plastic. In food industry we use high quality of plastic. They have capability to survive at hot temperatures. Okay, so thus preserving the integrity of the food or beverages inside it. And also plastic is inert. Plastic do not react with the food kept inside it. Okay, so thus preserving the integrity of the food. And it also protects our product from moisture, oxygen, dust, light and odors. So that was a basic introduction to plastic. Now let us move to next topic. So plastics are being divided into two major groups. So the first group is of thermoplastics and the second group is of thermosets. So let us know what are thermoplastics and what are thermosets. So, thermoplastics are those materials which can be heated and cooled repeatedly without appreciable loss of mechanical and physical properties. Okay, so among very wide range of thermoplastic which are used in large quantities in packaging are like polyethylene, polyvinyl chloride. Okay, we will learn all these kinds of thermoplastic in detail later. Now, what are thermosets? So thermosets are basically those materials which soften once on the application of sufficient heat but harden on cooling. Okay, they are rarely used in the field of packaging except in a small way of threaded closures made. Okay, the widely used plastics are thermoplastic because they are reused many times once heated. Okay, mean by heating it again and again, we can by heating it and cooling it repeatedly, we can use them again, but we can't use thermosets again. Okay, so let us read what are the definitions that are written on the screen. So thermoplastic is a type of plastic made up of polymer resins. Okay, like polyethylene पॉलीथाइलिन इट इज मेड अप ऑफ पॉलीमर ऑफ इथीन. ओके एंड लाइक ओके सो व्हाट इज रिटन हियर, थर्मोप्लास्टिक इज अ टाइप ऑफ प्लास्टिक मेड अप ऑफ अ पॉलीमर रीजन दैट बिकम्स अ सॉफ्ट मटेरियल व्हेन इट इज हीटेड एंड बिकम्स हार्ड व्हेन इट इज कूल्ड. ओके सो व्हेन एवर इट इज हीटेड इट बिकम्स सॉफ्ट एंड बिकम हार्ड व्हेन एवर इट इज बीइंग कूल्ड. ओके इट इज द बेसिक डिफरेंस बिटवीन थर्मोप्लास्टिक एंड थर्मोसेल्स. सो नेक्स्ट व्हेन थर्मोप्लास्टिक्स आर हीटेड देयर फिजिकल प्रॉपर्टी चेंजेस एंड दे बिकम अ होमोजेनाइज लिक्विड एंड बीइंग रीशेप्ड and resized. Okay, when they are being heated their physical property changes from solid to liquid, and when they are being cooled their physical property changes from liquid to solid, and they regain the shape of the container in which they are being set or in which they are being molded. Okay, so next thermosets. So thermosets are polymer in which a cross-linking reaction occur. Okay, so promoting chemical bonding between macromolecule chain, and these cannot be changed from their physical property does not change once heated. Okay, so thermosets are polymers in which a cross-linking reaction occurs, promoting chemical binding between macromolecular chains and creating a three-dimensional network. You all have studied these topics in your class 12th in the chapter polymers of chemistry. Next. So here is the first kind of thermoplastics, that is polyethylene. Okay, polyethylene. So polyethylene, here at the bottom is the structure of polyethylene. You all can see it. Okay, so polyethylene is being produced by polymerization of ethylene. It is being produced by polymerization of ethylene. Okay. So it is available in various densities. Okay, there is no fixed density of it. It has a wide range of densities with different properties. Okay, it has like ultra low density polyethylene, low density polyethylene, linear low density polyethylene, or high density polyethylene. Okay, so yes, moving further. So generally polyethylene refer to LDPE, like low density polyethylene and high density polyethylene. So in addition to above, medium density polyethylene, okay, in addition to LDPE and HDPE, there is also an MDPE that refers to medium density polyethylene. Okay, so the density range of medium density polyethylene ranges from 0.926 to 0.940. okay, its density ranges from between that. Okay, next is here are the terms that I am referring to. That is low density polyethylene, high density polyethylene, ultra low density polyethylene and linear low density polyethylene. So here are the definitions of these terms. Let us read them. LDPE is a soft, flexible, lightweight plastic material, and low density polyethylene is noted for its low temperature flexibility. It even can survive at low temperature and it is tough. Okay, it is being known for its toughness and it is corrosion free. Okay, and it is not suitable for applications where stiffness, high temperature resistance and structural strength are required. Okay, these are very flexible, very low temperature flexibility. Okay, they have very low temperature flexibility, and the densities of these ranges from 0.910 to 0.925. Okay, next is high density polyethylene. So yeah, it is a hydrocarbon polymer prepared from ethylene, okay, by a catalytic process. So it is a kind of thermoplastic which is a famous for its tensile strength. It has unique properties which can stand it even at high temperature. Low density, remember, low density polyethylene stands at low temperature, while high density polyethylene stands at high temperature. LDPE at low, high density polyethylene at high. Next, linear low density polyethylene. Okay, what is linear low density polyethylene and what is ultra low density polyethylene? So let us read. These are basically there is a difference in their densities. Okay, so yes, linear low density polyethylene. So linear low density polyethylene is one of the most flexible plastics, and it is one of the most flexible plastic sheeting films. So LDPE is blended form of LDPE. Okay, LLDPE is a blended form of LDPE, where the film has much more flexibility, tensile strength, and more comfortability. Okay, so it is more pliable and softer. So there is a difference between the densities of LLDPE and LDPE. So the density of LLDPE ranges from 0.900 to 0.940, and the density of LDPE ranges from 0.910 to 0.925. okay, so it is the more blended form and more flexible tensile and more conformable form of LDPE. okay, so and ULDPE means ultra low density polymer, and where is VLDPE means very low density polyethylene. Okay, moving to our main topic, what we were discussing. So their structures are also considerably different, and its advantage include high stiffness, improved environmental stress cracking resistance, okay, and heat distortion resistance. So yeah, I have told you polyethylenes are widely accepted for the packaging of food products as well as chemical owing to their inert character. They are inert, so yeah, they do not contact with the food material and do not spoil it. Okay, so yeah, there is a safety in contact with most food products as well as resistance to almost all commercially used chemicals. So moving to the next thermoplastic, that is polypropylene. Okay, so polypropylene is a polymer having low density. It has low density. So the density range of polypropylene is 0.90 gram per cc. Okay, the density range of polypropylene is 0.90 gram per cc. Okay, so the polypropylene have low density and they are extremely versatile. Polypropylenes are extremely versatile because of its excellent processability and physical mechanical properties and high heat distortion resistance. Okay, they are resistant to heat. Okay, and the major outlets are in the form of biaxially oriented cans. Okay, we can make cans and containers, box strippings, woven sacks, okay, from polypropylene. Okay, and yes, there is an intermediate bulk containers for food grains, onions, potatoes, sugar, etc., and metallized films for wrappers, laminates. Okay, the wrappers we are getting for wrappers and chips, they are being made from polypropylene, and they are extreme heat resistant. Okay, there is no effect of high heat on them, and they are excellent in physical and mechanical properties. So yeah, and they can be used for cans and containers production. So let us read what is written here. Polypropylene is tough, rigid, and crystalline thermoplastic produced from propene, and it is a linear hydrocarbon resin, and the chemical formula for polypropylene is written here, and the structural formula of this is here. Okay, you can draw the formula and draw the diagram of it. So polypropylene is among the cheapest plastics, and polypropylene is in many aspects similar to polyethylene. So special in solution behavior and electrical properties, and the methyl group improves mechanical property and thermal resistance. These are very much resistant to heat, although the chemical resistant resistance decreases. So the properties of polypropylene depends on the molecular weight and molecular weight distribution, crystallinity, type and proportion of co-monomer used in this. Okay. Moving to the next. So polystyrene, okay. So polystyrene is one of the most earliest and it is the oldest commercially available commodity plastic, and it is very versatile material because of its ease with which it combines with other polymer. It easily combines with other polymers to give desired properties. Okay. So there are two types of polystyrene. There are two types of polystyrene. One is GPPS and other is HIPS. Okay, GPPS stands for general purpose polystyrene and HIPS stands for high impact polystyrene. So GPPS is rigid and it is easy to process and it has good surface finish and it gives protection during transportation. While on the other hand, high impact polystyrene has improved mechanical and physical properties. Okay, so polystyrene, there is also an expandable, there is a type of polystyrene which is known as expandable polystyrene and is an excellent cushioning material. Okay, so the major outlet are injection blow molded bottles and injection molded containers, cushioning product protection during transport, and biaxially oriented films and thermoform disposable products like coffee and ice cream cups. The coffee and ice cream cups are being made from polystyrene. Okay, so let us read what is written here about polystyrene. First of all, do take a screenshot. Here is also an important figure of polystyrene. Okay, so yeah, polystyrene is a synthetic aromatic hydrocarbon polymer made from the monomer known as styrene. The polystyrene is styrene. The monomer of polypropylene is propylene and the the monomer of polyethylene is ethylene. Okay, so the monomer of polystyrene is styrene and polystyrene can be solid or foamed. Okay, so general purpose polystyrene is clear, hard and brittle. These are the physical properties of polystyrene. The general purpose polystyrene is clear as well as hard as well as brittle. So it is also a very inexpensive. Okay, so it is a poor barrier to oxygen and water vapor and hence a relatively low melting point. So polystyrene is one of the most widely used plastic and the scale of its production being several million tons per year. Next. Next is polyvinyl chloride. So polyvinyl chloride is also a versatile packaging material and it can be formulated with such a variety of additives that the range of physical properties, there are many physical properties of it because it can be formulated into variety of products. Okay, by adding additives in it, we can get too much of products with too much of physical properties. So there are endless physical properties of polyvinyl chloride. So the common example of polyvinyl chloride is the PVC pipes we generally use in our homes, and it is readily available in thickness that ranges from 0.002 to more than 0.02 mm. Okay, so it is a semi-rigid barrier type or highly flexible permeable films, and there are a variety of PVC packaging films available and they have a flexible type. Okay, they are flexible and can be used for larger volumes, and such films have dominated fresh meat packaging. Okay, we generally use polyvinyl chloride packaging for packing fresh meat, and this method is being used for more than 15 years. Okay, and these the property include like abundant oxygen permeability, okay, and excellent elastic memory. Okay, package stay tight. Excellent elastic memory means the package stay tight, airtight. Okay. But the air is permeable too. Okay, so yeah. And good sealability, okay, in for rapid in-store packaging. And when properly formulated, they are tough, extensible, and will not fog, okay. When packages are placed in cold supermarket meat display case. Next is like PVC films that are unaxially or biaxially oriented are also available for food packaging. So let us read what is written here. First of all, screenshot the structure of polyvinyl chloride. Next is polyvinyl chloride in two basic forms are rigid, okay, forms rigid and flexible. Okay, so the rigid form of PVC is being used in construction of pipes and in profile applications for doors and windows, and in it is also used in making plastic bottles, non-food packaging, food covering sheets and plastic cards. Okay, so it can be made softer and more flexible by addition of plasticizers. So the most widely used plasticizer is phytalates. I have told you that by adding other additives in polyvinyl chloride, we can get the desired properties that we want. So to make it flexible, we can add plasticizers in it. The common example of plasticizers is phytalates. So polyvinyl chloride is being produced by the polymerization of vinyl chloride. The monomer of polyvinyl chloride is vinyl chloride. Okay. Next is nylon. So nylons are also known as polyamides. Okay, so these are the long chain molecules with amide functionalities as an integral part of the repeating unit. Okay, so nylon films can be produced by both the blow films and cast film process. Nylon films can be produced by blow film as well as cast film process. Okay. So the high strength and the toughness of nylon are enhanced by biaxial orientation. Okay, so metallization of nylon films result in advantages such as improved barrier to moisture, oxygen properties, and good visual appeal. Okay, so in addition, these films have excellent flexibility flex crack resistance and anti-static properties and excellent printability. Okay, so nylons are tough and have a very high tensile strength. Okay, so nylons are very much resistant to abrasion and they exhibit very little cold flow or creep. Okay. And nylons are also slightly hygroscopic and the granules must be dried by heating before extrusion and molding. So yeah, one more thing I would like to add is some of the applications of nylons are vacuum and gas packaging of meats and cheese. Okay, nylons are being used in the gas and vacuum packaging of meat and cheese. Okay, so metallized nylon films are suitable for packaging of materials where retention of aroma is required. Okay, where the retention of aroma is required, there nylon films are suitable. Okay, so yeah, nylon are not particularly good barrier of water vapor. Okay, they are very good gas barrier, but they are not a good barrier of water vapor gas barrier. They are okay. So let's read what is written here. Let me erase all these things from the screen. Next, so nylons are condensation polymers or copolymers formed by reacting difunctional monomer containing equal parts of amine and carboxylic acid. So that amide are formed at both ends to each monomer in process analog to polypeptide biopolymers. Okay, so most of the nylons are made from the reaction of dicarboxylic acid with diamine or lactam or amino acid with itself. Okay, so in first case, the repeating unit consists of one of each monomer so that they can alternate in the chain. Okay, so similarly to the so-called ABAP structure of polyesters and polyurethanes. Next, so you all know nylon is a silk-like thermoplastic generally made from petroleum, and that can be melt processed into fibers and films or shapes. Okay, so yeah, nylons are very good, very much suitable for the packaging of meats and cheese. Nylons are particularly suitable for packaging of those materials in which retention of aroma is being required. Let us move next. Polyester. So, yeah. So, it is a homopolymer. Polyesters are a homopolymer. Okay, these are the homopolymer made from a dibasic acid or terephthalic acid or ethylene glycol. Okay, and the material has excellent clarity, rigidity, mechanical and physical barrier properties, and can be used in contact with most food products. So the major application of polyester is in the form of stretched and biaxially oriented bottles for beverages, including wines. Okay, the bottles we are getting for wines are made up of polyester. The qualities of polyester are clear, rigid, or mechanical, physical, and barrier properties. So it can be used in contact with most food products. Okay, so yeah, I have told you the major application of this is in manufacturing biaxially oriented bottles for beverages, including wine, and biaxially oriented films and metallized film as one of the substrates in laminates for packaging of food. Okay, so yeah, let us read what is written here. Polyester is a category of polymer that contain the ester functional group. Okay, and in every repeat unit of their main chain, they contain the ester functional group in every repeating unit of their main chain. So as a specific material, it is commonly most referred to as polyethylene terephthalate. Okay, so polyesters include naturally occurring chemicals in plants and insects. Okay, polyesters generally include, polyester is a homopolymer made from dibasic acid, terephthalic acid, ethylene glycol. So yeah, polyesters are also used to make bottles, films, tarpaulin, sails, canoes, liquid crystal display, holograms, filters, dielectric films for capacitors, film insulation for wires and insulating tapes. So this lecture is about the plastics in food industry. So you just have to remember that the bottles, the wine bottles are being made from polyesters, and the biaxially oriented films and metallized films, okay, are also made from this polyester. Okay, so the metallized film are one of the substrates in laminates for packaging of food materials. Okay, and also ovenable trays of frozen foods are also being made from polyester. Here is the structure of polyester. Next. Ethylene vinyl acetate. Okay, so the polymerization process for ethylene vinyl acetate copolymer is similar to that for LDPE. Okay, so ethylene vinyl acetate copolymer with high vinyl acetate content are used as additive for waxes and adhesives to improve the strength and barrier properties and processing characteristics. So of greater interest of packaging are the copolymers containing between 7 to 28% vinyl acetate. Okay, so these are the useful copolymers which contain 7 to 28% of vinyl acetate. So those containing 7 to 8% may be considered as modified LDPE, where those contain from 15 to 28% are more flexible, okay, and like PVC and all. So one advantage of ethylene vinyl acetate over PVC is that it's flexible and inherent and does not depend on the presence of plasticizers. I have told you that we add plasticizers in PVC to get the desired properties, but the ethylene vinyl acetate do not require any sort of plasticizers. So yeah, PVC require plasticizers and EVA is not dependent on any kind of plasticizers. Plasticizers generally can be lost by migration or leaching. Okay, so the properties of EVA compared to those of LDPE. I told you it is very much similar to LDPE. So what is the difference between ethylene vinyl acetate and LDPE? So that the ethylene vinyl acetate is more permeable to water vapor and gas, and it has greater elasticity, it has higher impact strength, and it is better at low temperature, okay, and it has a low temperature properties, and it has more resistance to environmental stress, cracking, okay. So yeah, ethylene vinyl acetate films have low slip and a greater tendency to blocking, so that a higher percentage of anti-blocking additives is necessary, okay. So the uses of ethylene vinyl acetate are packaging of fresh meat, cling film for packaging of fruits, foodstuffs, nutritional pouches, snap-on caps, liners for bag in box containers, and stretch wrappings, okay. So let us read what is written here about ethylene vinyl acetate. So yeah, I have told you everything about it. Let's summarize it by reading this. Ethylene vinyl acetate, also known as polyethylene vinyl acetate, is the copolymer of ethylene and vinyl acetate. So the weight percent of vinyl acetate usually varies from 10 to 40. With the remainder being ethylene. There are three different types of EVA copolymer which differ in the vinyl acetate, okay, content and the way the materials are used. So the EVA copolymer, which is based on a low proportion of vinyl acetate, may be referred to as vinyl acetate modified polyethylene, and it is a copolymer and is processed as thermoplastics material, just like low density polyethylene. So it has some of the properties of a low density polyethylene, but increased gloss, softness, and flexibility. So the material is generally considered as non-toxic. Next, ethylene vinyl alcohol. Okay, so films of ethylene vinyl alcohol are characterized by outstanding gas barrier properties. Okay, it has excellent resistance to odor and flavor permeance, as well as excellent processability, okay. So these films are particularly suited for foods like pickles, soup, processed meat, condiments, coffee, tea, juices, sauces, jams, edible oil, beer, or honey, and salad dressings, because of their special properties. They have special properties like they resist oils and organic solvents, thus making them particularly suitable for packaging of oily foods and edible oils. And they have excellent resistance to odor and flavor. And with an OH group in the molecular structure of this polymer, you can see an OH group here. So with an OH group in the molecular structure of the polymer, the film surface can be printed without pre-treatment. Okay, and yeah, so ethylene vinyl alcohol can be easily processed on conventional processing equipment. So let us read what is written here about ethylene vinyl alcohol. So ethylene vinyl alcohol is a formal copolymer of ethylene and vinyl alcohol. So because the latter monomer mainly exists as its tautomer acetaldehyde, the copolymer is prepared from polymerization of ethylene and vinyl acetate. टू गिव द इथाइलीन विनाइल एसिटेट ओके को पॉलीमर फॉलोड बाय हाइड्रोलाइसिस सो टू द फाइनल प्रोडक्ट इज इथाइलीन विनाइल एल्कोहल सो इव यू एच को पॉलीमर इज डिफाइंड बाय द मोल परसेंटेज इथाइलीन कंटेंट सो लोअर इथाइलीन कंटेंट ग्रेड्स हैव हाई बेरियर प्रॉपर्टीज हायर इथाइलीन कंटेंट ग्रेड्स हैव लोअर टेम्परेचर फॉर एक्सट्रूशन सो द Yes, the main points are these only. So, yeah, next is polyvinylidene chloride. Okay, PVDC. PVDC, okay. So, these are copolymers containing at least 50% vinylidene chloride. Okay, so more than 90% of the world production is used in food and medical packaging only. The more than 90% of the polyvinylidene is used in food and medical packaging. So the properties of PVDC film include low permeability to atmospheric gases, moisture and most flavor and aroma bodies. Okay, stress crack resistance to a wide variety of agents and ability to withstand the rigors of hot filling and retorting. Okay, so these are the major use of these are coating and film applications. Okay, so yeah, it is a remarkable barrier against water, oxygen and aroma. So it is it has a superior chemical resistance to alkalis and acid also. And it is insoluble in oil and organic solvents and has a very low moisture regain and is impervious to mold, bacteria and insects also. But it is soluble in polar solvents. It is one of the disadvantages of it. But yeah, doesn't matter anymore. So above 125 degrees Celsius, it decomposes to produce HCl. The major application of PVDC include packaging of poultry, cured meats and cheese, snacks, food, tea, coffee, confectionery, okay, and modified atmosphere packaging of food products, okay. So PVC stands for polyvinyl chloride, while PVDC stands for polyvinylidene chloride, and the difference between both of this is that PVC is made up of chloroethene monomer, whereas PVDC material is made up from vinylidene chloride. PVC is made from chloroethene and PVDC is made from vinylidene chloride. Okay, next. Ionomers, this is very important topic. So, yeah. The term ionomer was coined to describe a family of polymer in which there are ionic forces between the polymer chain. Between the polymer chain, there is an ionic force, okay? So, in addition to the normal covalent bonds between the separate atom and chain, in addition to those bonds, there is also an ionic force between the polymer chains. So, ionomers are basically copolymers of ethylene and metacrylic acid. And with some of the acid groups present in the form of a metal salt. So the polymerization process is again similar to that of LDPE. Ionomer are made by DuPont. DuPont. Okay, so under the trade name, Surlyn. So at room temperature, ionomers have greater resistance to oil and grease than LDPE. And although the difference are not so marked at elevated temperatures and the resistance to environmental stress cracking is good and is said to be higher than that of LDPE. So yeah, the characteristics of ionomer include they have exceptional toughness characteristics and the film toughness is the key requirement for cavity formed packaging as this property, okay. And along with adequate film thickness, imparts flex cracking resistance to package corners. Okay, so yeah. Vacuum packaging of large cut of fresh meats for box beef shipment represents the most important area where nylon and ionomer films are being used. Okay, so the high grease resistance of ionomers has opened up markets in foam fill seal pouches for convenience of foods with high added fat content. And the soups and seasonings and spices are the example of products which use ionomer seal layers in the form of seal packaging constructions. So yeah, these are known for their stiffness, toughness, okay, inertness also. So the ionomers are the polymer which are being composed of repeating unit of both electrically neutral repeating units and ionized units covalently bonded to the polymer backbone as banded group moieties. Okay, so usually not more than 15 mole percent are ionized. The ionized unit are often carboxylic acid groups. Next, polycarbonate. Okay, so polycarbonate is an amorphous resin that can be processed by all the conventional processing techniques. Okay, so polycarbonate has excellent dimensional stability, rigidity or impact resistance and transparency over a wide range temperature range. Okay, so it makes excellent structural layer in co-extruded and laminated packages of hot fill at 80 to 99 degrees Celsius. Okay, it has excellent dimensional stability, rigidity, impact resistance and transparency. Okay, so it can make an excellent structural layer in co-extruded and laminated packages for hot fills at 80 to 99 degrees Celsius, retorting at 120 degrees Celsius, autoclaving at 138 degrees Celsius and frozen food packaging. So yeah, polycarbonate can be sterilized with both gamma and electron beam irradiation with good stability. So these are the group of thermoplastic polymer containing carbonate groups. These are the group of thermoplastic polymers containing carbonate groups. And in their chemical, okay, carbonate group in their chemical structure, and polycarbonates used in engineering are strong, tough materials, and some grades are optically transparent. They are easily worked, okay, molded and thermoformed. So yeah, polycarbonate is a durable material, although it has high impact resistance. It has low stretch resistance, therefore a hard coating is being applied to polycarbonate IVL lenses. Okay, the IVL lenses, there is a hard coating is being applied because they has low scratch resistance. And yeah, polycarbonate is stronger and will hold up longer to extreme temperatures. And thermally processed material is usually totally amorphous. Okay, this is all about polycarbonates. Next are thermosets. Okay, we have completed thermoplastics. Okay, so what we have read in thermoplastic, we have learned polyethylene, polypropylene, polystyrene, polyvinyl chloride, nylon, polyester, ethylene vinyl acetate, ethylene vinyl alcohol, polyvinylidene chloride, ionomers, polycarbonates, and 2-3 more are there, like acidic copolymers of ethylene, polyethylene based adhesive resins, imide copolymers. Okay, so yeah, let us start with thermosets. So thermosets are those materials which soften once on the application of sufficient heat but hardens on cooling, and they are rarely used in the field of packaging except in a small way of threaded closures made out of phenol formaldehyde and urea formaldehyde. Okay, so they mainly include polyesters, allyls, amino epoxy furan, ionomer, phenol formaldehyde, urea formaldehyde, polyamides and silicones. Okay, so they are capable of becoming permanently rigid. Okay, they are capable of becoming permanently, sorry, excuse me, yes, so they are capable of becoming permanently rigid, okay, when heated or cured, thermosetting resin. Okay, so common example of thermoset plastics and polymers include epoxy, silicon, polyurethane, urethane, okay, phenol, like I've told you. So the main difference between thermoset plastic and thermoplastic is the thermoplastic can be reheated and reformed, while thermoset plastic cannot be remelted and remain in a permanent solid state once. Next. So how is plastic is used in food industry? Okay. So there are many applications of plastic in food industry. So plastic due to their versatility are making great inroads into the field of packaging of a variety of products. So plastic in the form of pouches, thermoformed tubes and box in box, okay, bag in box, tetra packs offer the advantage of convenience, okay, freedom from adulteration, ease of dispensing and disposal, safety in use, okay. So there are various advantages of plastic that are like ease of handling and storage and total prevention of repacking with other materials, which are major health hazard, and retailing in smaller unit pack gives protection from adulteration and is convenient for the weaker sections of society, and meeting the exact performance requirement by selection of different types of layer to the composite structure. Okay. So yeah. Plastic can be processed into any desired shape, and they are tamper proof, break resistant, corrosion resistant, and plastic packages do not pose any major disposal problem or environmental hazard, and since almost all plastics can be recycled for reuse, okay, so they can be sterilized by any of the conventional methods of sterilization, okay. So here are the limitations of plastic. So yeah, the limitations include low melting point, degradation of the environment, harmful for nature, durability, and some chemicals do attack at the particular phase. Okay, so yeah, and there are various kinds of hazards of it, like static hazard, mechanical hazard, transport hazard, climatic hazard, and other hazards are like some corrosive gases may cause stress cracking, and biological hazards such as bacteria, fungi and rats, and contamination by other products stored along with many which may have leaked, and fire also. Okay, so yeah, these all were the limitations and hazards from plastics. So yeah, that's all about plastics in food industry. Thank you for watching, and do visit our website www.foodtechnetwork.in.